some 300 miles to the east of Afghanistan, in the far north of Jammu and the Kashmir, amid a range of metamorphic peaks known as the Karakoram, stands a mountain of inconceivable height. Fashioned in rock as old as time itself, bounded by ice fields and wilderness, it is beset by strange atmospheric phenomena that bathe the summit in sinister silver light. This mountain is not visible from any inhabited place. It has no local name. And since its discovery in 1856 by a British survey team, it has mysteriously resisted every attempt to name it. The mountain is known simply and starkly by its original designation on the surveyor's map. K2. Assault on the world's most hazardous mountain. Turning their backs on civilization, they are flying into Skardu, where they will make ready to set off on their 100-mile trek through an uninhabited and spectacular snowscape. We'll be right back. commencing their ascent of the world's most savage mountain pause today to pay tribute at a simple cairn, a memorial to the many previous expeditions which have invariably ended in tragedy. Among them was Alan Rouse, the leader of the British expedition, and Julie Tullis, making their bid to be the first Briton. 26,000 feet. But the final 2,000-foot ascent to the summit is once again in the balance after a day of indecision and debate between the climbers about whether or not to proceed.
Different reasons pull us apart, alter our feelings. So I'm praying for the day to be alright and hide my tears away. Listens to reason, especially now I know you're lying and cheating. I don't wanna hear you sing, it doesn't mean a thing.
Yeah. Don't go.
Blur of flying snow.
In the Karakoram today, triumph has turned to tragedy with the deaths of five more climbers, including Alan Rouse and Rudy Tullis, perished during their descent after conquering the world's most mysterious mountain, K2.
We'll be right back.